Hey friends, I'm Devin, and today on Make Anything, I'm gonna show you how I used this filament to print this puzzle and this one. Wild, right? Let's do it. Cool. A couple of months ago, I made a video about this Snapmaker 3-in-1 machine here where I tested out all the various modules. So I laser cut some stuff, and I even CNC'd some little nut buttons for my boy. But the one thing that captured the most attention was actually my own little addition in this filament color blender. And the way this add-on works is it basically holds three Sharpies so that you can color your filament as it's going into the printer. So with that, I took white filament and was able to make all kinds of really cool, complex colored prints. Yeah, it's pretty powerful, and like many of you, I was absolutely fascinated by this technique, and I couldn't let it go. So today's video is all about exploring that technique a bit further by trying different markers, filaments, and machines to see how far we can take it. And by looking at the table in front of me, clearly I've been busy. But with all this said, I do want to make it absolutely clear that this isn't my own entirely original idea. In fact, all great ideas are usually based off of other great ideas. And in this case, well, coloring filament with Sharpies and other means has been done for years. For example, there's Billy Rubin, who started a YouTube channel relatively recently, but I remember something like 3 years ago, she shared a very similar print on Reddit. And I also remember Angus suggesting using spray paint to color filament. So there's all kinds of stuff that's been done, and like any great idea, it's built off of other great ideas. But, hear me out. Has anyone ever tried six Sharpies? I don't know. So we're gonna start there. That's right, the first thing I did was double the number of Sharpies for my filament blender. And that's because it was actually really easy to do in Fusion 360. All I had to do was double my three color blender, offset it a bit and give it a rotation, cut away any excess bits, and then merge it all together so that I have two blenders stacked right on top of each other. So now I've got this long channel that the filament feeds through, and it's got a Sharpie touching it every 30 degrees all the way around. So I printed that out and stuck it on my Snapmaker once more, fed in the filament, and started loading up all the Sharpies. For this first test, I threw in every color of the rainbow just to see what would happen. And it was pretty cool. The print definitely has a nice range of color, and it kind of looks like the surface of Jupiter, which is pretty cool. That said, I'm not sure adding more markers really made the colors more vibrant. By the way, unrelated, but this interesting little print is something that a fan named Elias designed and sent to me, and this is a nose flute, which you play by breathing out of your nose and using your mouth as the cavity. I've never heard of this before, but it's pretty fun. And I'm pretty good at it. Whoops. Next up, I wanted to try replicating one of the quad puzzles I printed with three Sharpies to get a really good direct comparison. So I printed out another quad using a similar set of colors as the three color version. And, well, here's the original three-color version, and here's the six-color version. So, there really doesn't seem to be any improvement in terms of strength of colors. If anything, it looks a little lighter, but that might be because I threw in some light pink and other lighter markers. I guess the three-marker version already got really good coverage on the outside of the filament, so adding more markers doesn't seem to do that much. But, what if we try some different filaments? I had a good feeling about this Matterhackers Pro PLA in translucent clear, and well, the results speak for themselves. Oh yeah, that is a completely stark black print being made with a clear filament. All of that color is coming from just three black markers. As it turns out, filament choice might be more important when it comes to getting strong colors with a filament blender versus just adding more and more markers. Of course, when filament runs through your printer, it's being melted and all of that Sharpie pigment is getting mixed in with the filament. So a lot of the color is actually inside of the print, but but if you have a high quality white filament that already has a lot of pigment, you're only gonna see the color that's on the very surface. On the other hand, if you have a clear filament, you can see straight through it. So all of that pigment is gonna show, and that's why you can get these really dark and strong colors. This Astrolabicon is a great example because both halves were printed with the same exact settings on the same printer with a single Sharpie using Matterhackers Pro filament. The only difference is I used white filament for one end and the transparent clear filament for the other. And here's that puzzle I printed out using three markers, which really evened out the color, giving us this nice dark black tone with just a bit of purple hues at the thinnest areas. So if you're trying to get really strong, vibrant colors, a clear filament will work the best. But I thought it might be fun to try some translucent colored filaments as well. So with this new discovery, I started diving through my filament collection, looking for my best translucent or less opaque filaments that I could experiment with. But I also wanted to experiment with a variety of different markers. So far, I've been using this 24-pack of colored Sharpies, but in order to test a few options, I just picked up these Shuttle Art markers, which are about half the price, as well as these dirt cheap black permanent markers by Amazon Basics. Those I basically got to see if I could cut costs, but another really interesting set of markers are these Sharpie metallic pens. Testing out the various black markers on paper, they do look pretty similar, although the Amazon Basics ink is maybe a little bit lighter, though I can't say I noticed a difference with the actual prints. But as I was saying, this metallic Sharpie is super interesting because just look at the amount of shine that comes off of that. The question is whether my printer can handle that metallic pigment and whether it'll show up in the print. So I immediately loaded up six of these Sharpies, and on the way in, well, we're definitely getting some good metallic coverage. So let's check out our print. I decided to print out one of my Galactop spinning tops. And at first glance, it actually looks really nice. We're getting a real metallic shine from this. But as I feared, this amount of silver pigment did seem to mess with the extrusion. And even when I raised the printing temperature, I kept ending up with some really crumbly prints. I was able to get more successful prints by switching back to just three markers, but that also reduces some of the metallic qualities. The pink end here was just printed with the regular Sharpie markers and it looks almost just as shiny, so I'm not sure that those metallic Sharpies are really worth the extra cost and effort to get a good print. Even when I tried mixing it in with other colors, that metallic quality kind of just got lost. So I think once again, this might be better dealt with on the filament end. In order to test several filaments, I wanted to test on several printers as well. So I jumped back into Fusion and designed a few different mounts so that I could stick this Sharpie blender on other printers of mine. I started with this little adapter for my Sovel SV01 printer and their new SV03, and I'm sure there are other printers with a similar extruder setup that this might work for. I got pretty lucky here that it was able to home without the marker hitting the gantry on the left side. So we are having some collision problems on the right here, so I am going to have a reduced area that I can actually print with. But besides that, everything else seemed to work just fine, and I was able to get colorful extrusions on these great direct drive printers. I also designed this more universal mount that uses a locking nut, so you can mount it on those T-slot aluminum extrusions that so many printers use nowadays. In this case, I stuck it on top of my BQ Thunder, which has an Olsen Ruby nozzle, perfect for printing this glow-in-the-dark PLA by Melt Ink. Look at that, instant colored filament. With this setup, the filament blender is a bit further removed from the hot end, but that's actually ideal for a Bowden setup like this. And it doesn't seem like the point of blending made much of a difference. I was still able to get a pretty dramatic color shift from this filament. Here's how those came out, super 90s looking. And as far as the glowing power, well, the Sharpie marker definitely does interfere with that a bit, but I still think it's a pretty fun effect. Next, I fired up my Sovel SV03 to print with this Polyalchemy Elixir filament. This is a super shiny, silky filament, and with the colors added, that shine remains. Yeah, it seems like going with a shiny filament like this might be a better option for getting that metallic look compared to using those metallic Sharpies. Despite the lack of extra saturation from adding more markers, I do still like using the 6-color blender just because it gives you so much control over the fine tuning of the colors you want to create. And by switching out one marker at a time while you're printing, it also helps you get slightly smoother gradations. Here's a pretty great rainbow I pulled off using that same Pearl Elixir filament. And I also got this pretty nice looking retro style astrolabicon using this Paramount 3D skin tone filament. And this is just a dirt cheap filament I got off of Amazon. But as it turns out, these cheaper filaments seem to work really well for this technique because there's less pigment. This filament was actually one of my favorites. I was able to get a lot of really nice, soft colors that look really elegant. I also made these really crazy striped pieces just by constantly taking the markers in and out of the blender while printing. This look is definitely among my favorites using this technique so far. Another pretty nice cheap filament was this Gizmodork's translucent pink. And not necessarily for its original color, but more so for what it can become with this Sharpie blender. I'm especially in love with this look, mixing in black Sharpie with the pink filament to get this really interesting and complex color. Using 3 Sharpies, you can get it to be nearly black, but then it still catches glints of a purplish pink in the light. And it's just a really cool look that I've never seen in any commercial filament that you can buy online. Here's another fun one printed with the neon translucent green. Here's the original color on the top, and I just brought in more and more blue to shift it into a darker green, which looks really nice on this end. And here I tried mixing in some red to get this kind of orange look as well. For a more subtle effect, I quite liked this ice blue transparent Pro PLA mixed with yellow to bring it more towards green or red to bring it towards purple. Somehow having the same base color ties it all together. I also tried that really fun stripey effect with the ice blue as well. All in all, I'm just blown away by the sheer variety of different looks that you can pull off using this one technique. And despite making all of these, I feel like I'm still just scratching the surface. Okay, so that just about wraps up my latest round of experimentation with this technique. I had so much fun doing it, and I've got all these awesome puzzles that I can't wait to put in my shop. As always, all these files for making your own Sharpie blenders will be available on My Mini Factory. Check it out. I can't wait to see all of you put this technique to use. And like I said at the beginning of the video, every great idea is built off of other great ideas. So my question for you is, how would you take this technique another step forward? I'd love to hear that from you. But until next time, I'm Devin. This is Make Anything. And as always, stay inspired.